have to have a CT scan to diagnose what type of stroke they're having so that you know what medicine to use. If you use the wrong medicine, you're going to kill whoever you're working on. CT scan is vital. You can't use the clockbuster without a CT scan. Blood. I had an emergency room personnel list three people that wouldn't be with us today if it were not for blood. So we have a situation here that is truly life and death. We also have accident situations. Ambulance. Dr. Herman got up and talked about an ambulance to be able to come to the facility. I think if you all will talk with your own emergency management professional here in the county, you'll find out that ambulance probably isn't going to the new facility they're building. So there's a lot of things that we're not sure about. There's a lot of things that we have half the information. Another issue is the money that Vida is supposedly losing quite at Pungo. They said $2.3 million. I've talked with officers of the corporation that own Pungo District Hospital, and they've told me they lost about $1 million a year. They don't know how it got to be $2.3 million. It sounds better, but it put in a big information system that cost a lot of money in Bellhaven. Vida spent a whole lot of money that is not reoccurring expenses. So when Dr. Herman gets up and says we're losing $2.3 million a year, then we don't know how accurate that is, because we don't believe all those are reoccurring expenses. So we have a situation where Biden is pushing to do what they want to do, and it's to the detriment of the people in Bellhaven. One of the things that's a big concern, and I think the commissioners need to realize, is that Dr. Herman at our forum said that the same emergency staff personnel we have at the hospital now will be at the new facility. Some of you all were there and heard that. Right. He sent out a letter the next day to the emergency room personnel and said that was a misstatement.
Oh.
So there's a lot of misinformation going on. And when you hear a man saying $2.3 million of expenses, and we know it was about $1 million, we just are concerned about what's going on. We're concerned that Vida is just trying to get through what they went through. Time is of the essence. I'm so glad you called this meeting. We have to get to Vida as soon as possible and let them know that any facility that doesn't include emergency services, emergency room services, is unacceptable. And they say what they want to, but ambulances are not going to be stopping in Bellhaven. Now, next Thursday afternoon, tentatively, we have a meeting set up with Dr. Herman and some of his staff. I hope that two or three of the county commissioners will go with me to that meeting. I know a couple of you already pledged for that.
What time is that?
It's going to be in the afternoon. They're going to call me back tomorrow, the next thing, give me the time. Next Thursday afternoon, October 10th.
That's in Greenville?
Yeah. So anyway, we're looking forward to that meeting. Hyde County, the county manager is going to be there as well. We're going to try to have some of their county commissioners so we can all get there and get the facts as to what we're going to have and not have. And then I think it comes to a situation where we need to make it known what our expectations are from Vida Health in our area and what we expect as far as treatment goes. So anyway, if anybody got a question,
I'll answer. Okay. When you said that Dr. Herman said that was a misquote, if I remember correctly, he said that about 49% of the people that work at Bellhaven Hospital right now will be employed at the new facility. And he said that's not true. Now it's not true.
No, what he said was, when he was talking about the emergency room and what the new facility will have as far as emergency room capabilities, he said the emergency room staff that you go to right now when you have an emergency, they will be the people you go to at the new facility. And that is not true. And he sent an email.
So he's backed up on that.
Yes. And once again, the other thing that concerns me is $2.3 million in expenses. That's simply a blown up number.
I think they say $6,900 a day is what they're
worth. $6,500 a day. And once again, that number is based on capital expenses they made that aren't reoccurring. So that's misleading, and that's what I'm concerned about, because we're dealing with an issue that is beyond misleading. We don't need to be misleading. We need to be talking about facts here.
Just one more question. How many patients Bellhaven admits per week?
I don't know. I know the numbers have been less recently due to Dr. Boyette. It's had a situation where they were working him so hard that he had to make some other arrangements. But he's been a great supporter of the hospital and has done all he can to help us all he can. but I know that they have done some things business-wise, whereas they could promote the clinics more, which would help the hospital, but they've been taking the doctors and running them back and forth to the hospital and emergency room. So, for example, let's take Dr. Jones, he's trying to run a practice, and in the middle of the day, he's got to run the emergency room for an hour, then come back, then he goes back, and they won't hire a hospitalist. I understand that's one of the doctor's complaints, and what that's doing is hurting the hospital. So there's mechanisms that they're letting take place that are actually hurting the hospital, and they don't have any interest in rectifying.
Does any other commissioners have a question?
Yeah.
For the mayor before he sits down?
Yeah, I do. Have you got any negotiating chips with Biden? I remember when we were dealing with Biden, the only negotiating chips we had were opposing bids, and then they got all squared off by the concerned citizens for UHS, one bid only process. And so we lost our chips, and we gave away our hospital. Do you have any chips that you have?
We have the biggest chip of all, the truth.
That didn't help us here, but
we have the truth because we have, you were different here. You had a public that was split. You had a public that supported Biden.
And we Belhaven, had some of the public.
In Belhaven, there's nobody supporting Biden. Everybody 100% is against what they're doing because it's flat and wrong.
Yeah, that's good.
And I don't think they want the whole world knowing what they're doing, and that's who's going to find out if we don't get treated fair.
Dan, is there anything else?
No.
I like that.
Any other county commissioners before you close? Go ahead, Mr.
We're trying to get a declaration by other county commissioners, high county commissioners. Belhaven's already done it. The U.S. senators, the state senators, state representatives, and the U.S. congressmen, they all tell Biden that we must have emergency room services in Belhaven. And that's what we'd like to ask you all to do tonight, is do something that has some wording that says emergency room, we need an emergency room, is vitally necessary in Belhaven. So that then we'll be able to carry those in our meeting and show them that it's unanimous support that this is the right thing to do. And if they want to do the wrong thing in the face of everybody in harmony, tell them the right thing to do, that's up to them. They have to live with that.
Okay.
Yeah.
I've got one thing to say.
Go ahead.
This is before the meeting when you and I spoke, and I thought it would be good if we had a special call meeting as you did, and we get something put together as soon as possible. A lot's happened since then. We did not put together a resolution because we thought it would be best to have you up here and receive as much input from you as possible. I guess what I'm saying is it would be imperative at this point, since you're seeking what you are seeking, which is a unified front, that we get as much out of you, pick your brain, we'll write just as stronger resolution as possible by consensus on this board, if should that be the case, and do what we can to help. Again, while you have your negotiating chip with the truth, we have very little in negotiating chips to use with Biden, other than we would like for them to treat our fair city to the east as fairly as possible.
Well, you have the full power and integrity and strength of the Burke County Commissioners. And if you make a resolution that has emergency room services in it and it's unanimous, that does carry weight.
We would love to have you help on. 45,000
people.
I can't imagine it be a unanimous vote on that resolution.
I sure hope so.
Mr. County Manager, in relation to this meeting next month, I guess we can have up to three county commissioners go to that meeting.
That's correct.
Is it possible for me to appoint that committee at this point without the chairman being here, since I'm acting chairman?
That would be fine.
Okay.
If I could ask.
Yes, sir.
Hood or Stan, one of them be on there, I would appreciate that. I'd like to request that. I know Hood's got a lot of experience with it.
Well, I'm out of town, and Hood is a much better advocate than you myself. So, I would like to Hood on there. Should he want to be on there?
If I'm working in my schedule, I'll be glad to do it.
Okay. Who else would like to be on there?
I'll be on.
You'll be on there? And I'll be on there. Okay. Three people on the committee are Gary Brennan, Hood Richardson, and Al Clem.
Thank you, Al.
They are appointed.
Very proud of the representation you'll have there. That'll be strong.
And I thank you very much. And And Stan, you're the one that requested the meeting with...